I would make just one comment and have one general question for the three of you on the comments. As to the quality of the source, and the point you almost mentioned that as well. Well, I think that I personally, in my experience, I find the quality of the source a very, let's say, tricky subject. And for the following reason, I have primarily life sciences customers, and sometimes I simply have to go with the existing situation. I can have, let's say, the source file, and the customer has ownership over the source. They don't have a content management system, they have technical writers, and they, at some point, we have a certain source file that the person wants to translate. Well, we do our incoming inspection, and very often we see that the source file is, to use your word, crap. So, if we make a mistake, and we start, being less customer friendly, and we start, correcting the source 150 pages, that means that we will have, that it's going to be a very costly affair, and it's going to impact our margin. So I think it's very wise, also for a vendor, and maybe most of you are doing that, to go back to the customer, and that's what we have basically done. And we offer them two options, that, we can review the source for you, and it's going to be so much euro, or if you want us to go ahead with the source, the output will have the same quality as your source. And that's sometimes a little bit, a difficult negotiation. I think it's very wise for us vendors to make sure that when we start translating, that we feel very comfortable with somebody able to translate. That's one thing. That goes to the general. And the second is a question about the key performance indicators. So we haven't talked about quality of the deliverable. And I think, I think that Sylvia also mentioned that we haven't really started to collect the data on responsiveness. And you were just mentioning it at the time. If I would take those three main key performance indicator as a scope, let's say quality of the output, responsiveness of the vendor, and the type of delivery, how would you rate those three? Do they have equal importance for you, or would you rate one higher than the other? It's a question for the three of you.
That's a really good question, but I want to, I want to make a comment about your comment. And I think, Lou, you bring a really good point, that it is important that, you're measuring and looking at quality. And actually, I'm actually answering the question. It is important. And to me, I think the level of services is the most important. Because that's how, if I ask for something and I don't get it right away, it's just, if I'm asking for things and the vendor's not answering, I need a quote and I need it right away, we have so little time in a lot of the projects. And back to the source, I think it's a good point that you said, the vendor should offer, and we expect that the vendor offer this and come back to us. And that's level of service, by the way. So I think it's a really important thing that the vendor offers. And now we're willing to pay for that time. So I would put it at the highest level. But sometimes you don't have time to look at the source at all. It's like go, go, go. And you have caca and you get more caca. And it's just bad, bad, bad from the very beginning. But I would say it's the level of service that I perceive the most.
For us, it's slightly different, maybe because I have the project management team who can help work on the level of service. So I would say for us, maybe 40% would be the language quality, 30% would be the project management and level of service, and 30% would be the timeliness of the deliverables.
Yeah. But would you say that timeliness is part of it?
Yes. Yeah, so then it basically equally important with a slightly higher emphasis on the translation quality. And I didn't have the case with a vendor, but I did have it with a reviewer, actually, one of our reviewers for a European language whose output was great linguistically. The Spanish team loves her. She's difficult to work with, not always responsive, not always reliable, takes a vacation whenever she wants without letting us know in advance. And we ended up
basically relegating her to a secondary or even a tertiary reviewer, because yes, she's great, but we're not willing to put up with this stuff anymore. So it's level of service, just Sylvia says, is important.
Yeah, just to build on that, the initial comment with regard to content, and I think that's so important, but it's established in the contract to say, okay, we are not responsible for errors in the source. We're going to be reflected in the translation. So that's one way to protect ourselves. I think that's an excellent point. The other one that relates a little bit to the other topics in the seminar, the idea of transformation and reinventing yourself, and actually, the businesses that are successful are the ones that are really able to adapt and transform themselves as the business and the world around them change. So in our sense, we actually end to end. So we can provide the blade, but we also provide content development, so that's a service that we get to hand and do offer to our clients and the infrastructure broadly. So it's from content creation to fulfillment. We provide that service, and then that helps tremendously in some cases to do what we call engineering. And what it does is it's really advising clients on how to create, how to make sure that your message is the most effective. So we find different ways. That's not only related to translation, but we can also help our clients. In terms of the second question, that's such a tricky question. It's a very good question. I'm very afraid of, okay, just pointing to one thing or another, but I would say that if we try to represent ourselves as a quality company, and because there is so much liability that we are exposed to, so we definitely put quality first. And just like you mentioned, yeah, we have, and we try to ensure that, you know, some not so easy to work with translators, however, have an excellent output. So we try to manage our channel projects their way that will kind of make us both happy, if you know what I mean.
Just
going to
add one more comment to what you mentioned, Leo. We do hold vendors accountable for what they give us. So if there were mistakes in the source and they didn't tell us, we're going to hold them accountable for the final quality. That's why we always encourage our vendors, if there are problems in the source, you better tell us. Don't just replicate the mistake, and then when someone finds out, what is it? Well, it was in the English, it's not my problem. No, we do hold them accountable. So I would like to encourage all of you, if there are source mistakes, go to the client immediately. They do have ways and channels most of the time how to fix things. Plus, they might be using 3 or 4 different vendors. If only one vendor spots the mistakes, the other vendors might not. So many times we get some feedback from Japanese, and then we tell the people in Latin America and Europe, guys, by the way, our vendor found this, be careful, please change this to this and that.